On this Mother's Day weekend, we wish you a very, very happy Mother's Day. In Hebrews 12, verse 11, it says, "All discipline for the moment seems not to be joyful, but sorrowful. And yet, to those who have been trained by it, afterwards, it yields the peaceful fruit of righteousness." Well, isn't that the way it is? As a child growing up, many times we didn't like the discipline, but now, the older we get, we realize how wise that was. And so, this weekend, we express our thankfulness in prayer to our mother for how she raised us and helped us to develop into who we are today. In Proverbs 6, verses 20 and 23, it says, "My son, observe the commandment of your father, and do not forsake the teaching of your mother. Bind them continually on your heart." Now, heart, we've talked about this. This is your subconscious mind, not what is beating in your chest. "Tie them around your neck," it says. "And when you walk about, they will guide you. And when you sleep, they will watch over you. And when you awake, they will talk to you. For the commandment is a lamp, and the teaching is a light, and the reproofs for discipline are a way of life." We thank our mother in prayer today for her incredible wisdom that she gave us. And we rethink this weekend about some of those teachings and some of the guidance. And we remind her in prayer that we will always hold what she taught us close inside of our heart, and we'll wear it in our actions and our reactions. In Timothy 1, verse 5, it says, "But the goal of our instruction is love from a pure heart and a good conscience and a sincere faith." While growing up, especially in our teen years, many of us have probably felt at one time or another that our parents' discipline was too strong, too strict. Over the years, however, as I said before, we've come to realize that our parents disciplined us with great wisdom and because they loved us. Well, in prayer today, we thank our mothers for expressing that kind of sound instruction, even when it would have been difficult. See, many times we thought it was difficult, but how much more difficult it was for our mothers to keep on keeping on to teach us. 1 John 3, verse 18, "Let us not love with word or with tongue, but in deed and in truth." How many times your mother taught you through her actions, you learned what it was like to be a good human being through her actions, more than her word or with her tongue. In 1 Corinthians 13, 13, it speaks this truth, "But now faith, hope, love, abide these three, but the greatest of these is love." Well, how many times your mother expressed all three of these things in your life? Well, tell her so this weekend in prayer with a thankful heart. In Psalms 139, 13, it says, "For you formed my inner parts. You wove me in my mother's womb." There was a co-creation going on of you, God, the Creator, and your mother, the co-creator, helped to form you and helped to make you who you are. And then it talks about God's love, and it compares that to your mother's love. Isaiah 66, verse 13, "As one whom his mother comforts, so I will comfort you. Think about all the comfort that you received from your mother. And if she's still here on this side of life, express that to her. And if she's crossed over, express it to her still in prayer. And thank God also, and you will receive a mighty comfort as your mother comforted you. Happy Mother's Day. God bless you.